Welcome back to Adventures with Vehicles. This is a old Chevrolet military truck, M1008, I believe. You can correct me if I'm wrong. 6.2 liter diesel, turbo 400 trans, Dana 60 front end, 14 bolt rear end, has 42 original 1,000 miles on it. Super clean truck. Hardly any rust on it. It used to be a radio truck. It was the light duty trucks that the military used. We'll get some video of this thing driving and hopefully you guys like it. We're driving the old Chevy here, the old military truck. Not the fastest thing in the world, these 6.2 diesels. They were governed at 55 mile an hour for military purposes. They're real geared, real low. Thing drives down the road nice. 6.2 diesels are a little noisy, so are the 6.5s. Both these trucks came with both of those motors. About 55 mile an hour is as fast as it's going to go. Maybe you might be able to get it to 70. If you're going down a steep ass hill, wide over throttle, but you don't want to turn one of these that hard. Thing runs nice, drives nice, goes down the road straight. Good running truck. Has 42,902 miles on it. So it barely even broke in. Anything you want to pull, and it'll probably go anywhere you want it to go. Military used these for moving small trailers and equipment around, and this was also a radio truck that was outfitted with a radio. I don't know much about these military trucks, but I do know I really like this one. And eventually this guy will probably be selling this one, so you can hit me up on my Facebook page for more information on that if you're serious. Make offers. These trucks are rising in value as we speak. Only downfall about these trucks is they don't have AC. I'm fat. I like AC.
Put some vintage air in this tank.
Yeah, definitely put some vintage air.
It's got that dump lock in the rear.
Yeah. What'd you call it?
Is it called gun lock or something? Usually if you get on it a little bit on a turn, you can hear it bark the tires a little bit on that.
Oh, it has lockers in it? Yeah. Right. Yeah, these did have
Detroit locker.
Yeah. These did have lockers front and rear. I'm not mistaken. That was probably the military option. But yeah, I really like this truck. Not the fastest thing in the world, but it'll get you anywhere you want to go. And this truck will run on diesel fuel and I believe kerosene, waste motor oil, straight oil, vegetable oil. And it was a 12 and 24 volt truck. So it had 24 volts and 12 volts. You can, I don't know how exactly it works. You probably go and figure it out. It's a pretty neat truck. It has a plug on the front end that you can plug into it, and you can run a welder off of it, a jump box or whatever. And I'll show you how you can hook a welder up to one of these things, which is pretty cool as well. So you say you're out in the field and something breaks, you can plug it. It has a round plug in the front of the truck that you can plug a welder into, and
just trying to get it steady.
Yeah. All right, well, here is the Here is the GoWell welder that I picked up off of a military surplus webpage that I was going to put on my personal truck that happens to fit my buddy's truck. Here, hold this for me. Which happens to fit my buddy's truck. And it just plugs in like so. And then you can hook the welding leads and go to the spool gun, which is here in the case. You can either hook them up to these plugs here, or you can hook them up to these plugs and run them directly off a battery. And this runs on 12, 24, or 36 volts. And but this truck produces 12 volts and 24. Get you a look at that socket there. I would assume one of them is going to be the positive, one's going to be the negative. I would say the outside's the negative and the inside's the positive, if you were wondering if you had one of these. And what makes me say that is if you look at the outer shielding and then look at this, it's grounded to the outside, so that is obviously ground. But that's how you hook a welder up to the front of one of these pickups. Or any military truck that has that plug on. Hummers have those. The old K5s did. Some of the 5-tons, and a lot of the trucks that decided they could service them if they broke on the road or out in the field. These switches here, I'll show you what they do on the front. They're blackout lights. I believe, I might be wrong, but these lights on the front right here are for when they are running no lights, and I guess it's so you can see if the truck is, when you're using night vision, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong, correct me if I am. But, and this plug here, they could use this to jump trucks with, and you can also use it with a welder. I have a welder you can plug into this. And you can definitely tell the military used this truck bed, because they definitely hauled some heavy stuff in it and they used it for sure. These may have been military, I'm not sure. Let me know in the comments. And let me know if I missed anything on this truck in the comments as well. Or correct me if anything I said was wrong. And this is the radio mount that I was talking about that they use for radio antennas. His antenna got snapped off by a tree branch, but this was an old radio truck, and there's a plug right there that the radio would have connected to for that antenna. this was an add-on, but this is the pedal hitch that the military used, which swiveled, which kept the trailer from tilting, from flipping over. And then it used a different style plug. And then again, it has the blackout light that I was showing you on the front and on the switch on the dash. Where the gun mount for the butt of the gun sat, and then up here is where the barrel would have locked in. I don't know if you can see that well, but
that speaks for history.
These right here were used for when when it was cold outside, they'd keep the engine warm since it's a diesel. And this right here pulls right off. And it's that plug I was talking about earlier for a welder or jump in the truck. And I'll hook a welder up there because I personally own a welder for one of these, because I was going to put one of these military style plugs on my dually so I can weld. Thank you for tuning in with Adventures with Vehicles. Thank you for watching the video on this amazing Chevy truck, military truck. Let me know if I missed anything on it, and if I did, please correct me in the comments. If you have any vehicles like this you want me to cover or have any knowledge on this vehicle at all, please leave in the comments so other people can learn. Correct any mistakes I said, please. And follow me on Facebook and let me know if you want me to do more future stuff like this. Especially like 5-ton Hummers, if you have something like that, let me know. Contact me on Adventures with Vehicles on Facebook. And I will try to get out to you. And I'd love to shoot anything you have.